And Rajalakshmi, Assistant Professor, Faculty of Agricultural Sciences, Bharat Institute of Higher Education and Research. I'm handling the course on Protected Cultivation and Secondary Agriculture, and we are going to discuss about physical properties. And in the physical properties, we are going to discuss about size, shape, sphericity, density, and specific gravity. And also like aerodynamic properties like terminal velocity and drag coefficient. So these properties play a major role in designing an agricultural machinery. So if we determine these properties, it helps to design an agricultural machinery based on our requirement. Now we are going to discuss about physical properties. So physical properties means it is an important properties which helps to designing and machineries, or it helps to study about those agricultural process product during this processing operation, such as size, shape, density, specific gravity, volume, porosity, and surface area. So there are a number of physical properties which plays a major role. But particularly, so these physical properties, such as size, shapes, and up to surface area, so these are all the important physical properties, so which helps in the machine designing operations. So if you want to design these machineries, you have to note it down about these physical properties, which helps to design a particular machine based on our requirement. So what are those important physical properties? Why these physical properties? Mostly these physical properties helps in designing a cleaning unit, such as if you want to remove the dirt material or else any stone away from the particular product. So this cleaning unit plays a major role. Grading unit means if you want to grade those products, such as apples, how they are grading is based on the size. So if size and the color, so if a product is sold to the similar sizes, means it is purchased to the more prices. So this grading unit plays a major role there. And separating unit means if you want to separate the which are like the fractions of fraction rather, that which means paddy or else with the dust or separated paddy. So if you want to separate it, the separating unit plays a major role. Handling unit means which helps in the easy transportation. And shorting unit means this is a unit which uses an optical system which helps to separate those agricultural products. So if you want to separate an pure white colored rice and dull colored rice, means these sorting machineries which helps to separate this rice product, or else fruit, it is also useful in separating the fruits also, and it helps in the storing, designing and storing system, and also drying system. So for these designing machineries operation, physical properties plays a major role there. And next comes size and the shape. Size means which is a rigid form of the body, and shape is the rigid form of the body, and size means measure of the dimension. So normally it helps in designing and screen opening. And next one is selection of this disc. So selection of the disc is a main important characteristics in determining the size and shape of the machineries. Then adjustment of the cylindrical clearance. Then adjustment of the cylindrical clearance means, so if you want to thresh a paddy, so if you have those, if you know that size, approximate size of those paddy means, if you set a fixed clearance, fixed cylindrical clearance means, you can get an threshed paddy with more efficiency. If it is not designed in a proper way, means what happens is rice will get broken and you can't get a more prices. Okay, if you want to sell those paddy, you can't purchase for a more prices. Then angle of inclination, so this helps in the hopper designing. So if you are loading those machinery, means if the angle of inclination is more, means what happens, the more the product will suddenly enter into the machine operation. So if you load more, the more product will enter into those machinery operation, which leads to the failure of the machinery. If the angle of inclination is very less, means the product will move very slowly, and what happens there is the machine won't get the continuous operation, okay? And you may have loss in the power while running of those machineries. Then vibration amplitude and the frequency, and these are all those important operation. These are all those important parameters while designing an clearance or else cleaning unit. Okay, and next one is roundness. So roundness means it is used to measure the sharpness of the product, and the roundness, which is the ratio of area of projected area divided by smallest circumscribing circle. And next is roundness, which can also be determined by using the radius of curvature divided by radius of maximum inscribed circle, and where n into the total number of corners. And the roundness is the ratio of radius of curvature of the sharpest corner to the mean radius of the object. And sphericity. Sphericity means it is the cube root of volume of the solid to the volume of the circumscribed circle. And it may be defined as the ratio of surface area of the sphere, which is having the same volume as that of the particle, and the ratio of the solid to the volume of the circumscribing circle, which is also determined the sphericity. So this is shown in the image. So this is the ratio of this DZ, where DZ is the diameter of the circumscribing circle, DI is the diameter of the inscribed circle. So if you know this cube root of the volume of the solid, so this volume of the solid can be obtained by drawing in the graph. So as by drawing in the graph, we can be able to know the volume of the solid in terms of millimeter cube, and volume of the circumscribing circle. So circumscribing circle is this one. If you know these volume, you can be able to calculate the sphericity. And same thing, if you have the surface area of the sphere, which is having the same volume as that of the particle, and if you want to calculate this one, you have to calculate the surface area of the sphere having the same volume, okay, and to the surface area of the particle. And the next one is, you can be able to calculate it with the ratio of the solid. So this one to the volume of the circumscribed circle. And this one, if you know, if you calculate this one, you can be able to calculate the sphericity. And the sphericity, almost all spherical objects will tend to approach the value of 1. And the value of sphericity, which will ranges from 0 to 1. And an orange, which is having a sphericity in order of 0.95. And paddy, which is having the sphericity, so it will approach to an oval shape. So paddy, which have a sphericity ratio of 0.13 to 0.15. And sphericity and the safe factor is also needed in a heat and mass transfer calculation. So if you have the size, shape, sphericity, volume, surface area, and density and porosity. So these are all the important parameters while designing and handling and processing operation machineries. And normally fruits and vegetables, which will be graded according to their size, shape, density also. And density and the safe factor are also necessary for predicting and predicting the freezing and thawing rate. So freezing and so if a particle is very dense, means what happens is it will take more time to achieve freezing, complete freezing. And same thing, if the if you want to unfreeze those product, what you are doing is you have to thaw those product. So these time will differ based on this density and safe factor of this product. And if you want to measure the size, and you can use these vernier calipers by using a projection method, and or also you can use the traveling microscope in order to observe this size of this product. And this is a vernier caliper. So if you want to measure the size, which is having an approximately a bigger size, means you can use these external jars, and for measuring an outer dimension. And if you want to measure an inner dimension, means you can use these upper jars for measuring an inner dimension. And this one is known to be the main scale, and it is the stem for measuring the depths. If you want to measure the depth, you can use this method. And this is the normal vernier scale, we have seen it. Now it is improvised, we can use this electronic vernier scale, and it is having a power control button, which is used to control this, and so we can be able to control these operations. And density and specific gravity, density, which is defined as the mass of the product divided by volume of the product. Normally, density means mass by volume. And this is used in designing of those silos, bins, and most of the silage materials, and separation of those crops, and sorting and grading of the machineries, and also material evaluation, maturity evaluation. So density and specific gravity, which plays a major role in designing of the silos and storage bins. And the separation of these desirable materials, and we can be able to separate this material also. Then comes true density, bulk density, and apparent density. So then we are going to discuss about true and the bulk density. So then bulk density, true density, and the porosity, which is representing the amount of intergranular space to the total space which is occupied by the grain. So then normally why these densities which plays a major role here is, if you want to design a grain hopper or any storage bins, you want to know, you have a clear cut idea about this density and specific gravity and porosity of the material. So if you know these values, then you can approximately or else accurately able to design an bulk density, or else sorry, accurately you can able to design a silos bin. And this can also affect an rate of heat transfer. So if this material is highly dense, means it won't place a major role in heat and mass transfer operations and during the aeration and drying process. And density, which is used to separate the material with the different densities and specific gravities. Then normally grain depth with a low porosity, which have the greater resistance to the water vapor, and it won't allow the water vapor to escape during this drying process. So normally low porosity is chosen. Then with the high power drive with the aeration fan. Then the cereal grains, which is having a higher density, which is having interest in the breakage of susceptibility and hardness studies. And for instance, bulk density plays a major important role in other application, includes designing of and silos and storage bins. As I discussed earlier, so these are used in designing of the silos and storage bins. And the resistance of the bulk grain to the airflow, which is an important function in determining the porosity and the kernel size. So if you want to design a bin, you should have an idea about the resistance which is offered by the bulk grain to the airflow. Okay. And if you know these parameters, then you can able to design, you can get a clear cut idea about, so how much storage facilities we have to need in order to store these grain facilities. And density, which is defined as a mass per unit volume. Normally it is denoted by kg per meter cube. And these are also different form of the density, which is true, particle, material, apparent density, that is used depending upon this product application. Normally true and material density are calculated by the volume which is occupied by the internal force and the external force within this foot. So bulk density and particle apparent density are less accurate measurement, and where bulk density includes the pore volume. Porosity, which is defined as the ratio of this volume of the white space to the volume of the air, white space or air space inside the material. So if a particle which is said to be this high porosity, means it will have more white space, which means it can be able to absorb more amount of water. Then volume determination with relative to the amount of internal or external force which is present in the food structure. And the density and different form of the porosity are also used in food processing studies. And namely, more open pore, closed pores, apparent and total porosities, which plays a major role. And porosity, which is a relationship of volume of intergrain space to the total column of the grind mass. And the porosity normally determined as a ratio of this true bulk density divided by true density. So 1 minus bulk density divided by true density. And porosity, which is determined by an experimental method, so which is consist of a tank 1 and the tank 2, which is known to be the air pygmometer method. So what we are doing is, we are allowing the air first in the first tank. What we are doing is, we are allowing the air to pass it through it, and second tank we are filling it with the sample. And based on the difference in the weight, we can able to calculate the porosity of these samples. And leaf surface area by using an graphical method or planimeter method. And this consists of apple, pears, egg sperm. So these are all the calculated values. And if you know the weight of the fruit and the surface area, we can able to, sorry, if you know the weight of the fruit, we can able to calculate the surface area of this materials, okay, or food products. And the specific gravity, which is also a dimension unit, which is defined as the ratio of one substance to the density of the water. Specific gravity is normally determined by the ratio of this density of the substance to the density of the water at normal temperature, usually 4 degrees Celsius. Normally, density of water is 4 degrees Celsius as a reference. And water point, which is having a higher density, will be about 1000 kg per meter cube. And this is a diagrammatic representation. So this shows that density, which is defined as the normal occupied by the substance to this specific gravity, which is defined as the ratio of this density of the substance to this density of this water medium. And the specific gravity, density of the substance, if the specific gravity is more than 1, which is known to be the density of the substance divided by density of water at 4 degrees Celsius. So if this specific gravity is more than 1 means, what happens is water will be at a lifted one higher height when compared to the other material. So specific gravity is density of the substance divided by density of water at 4 degrees Celsius. Then the specific gravity. So there are specific gravity, which is normally calculated by the product of weight in the air into specific gravity of water divided by weight of displaced water. And there are different methods: suspension method, density column method, platform method, specific gravity balance method, and the relative density bottle method. And the shrinkage. So shrinkage, which is defined as how much amount, or else how much volume that the material can be able to shrink. So, or else geometrical dimension, which it will help to study about the geometrical dimension during the processing operation. There are two types of the shrinkage of material. One is isotropic and anisotropic. And isotropic shrinkage is uniform the shrinkage. So throughout the surface, the material will get shrinked uniformly. Or anisotropic shrinkage means, which is non-uniformity. So what happens is, the structure of this material will get collapsed during this shrinkage, anisotropic shrinkage. And the former is common in normally fruits and the vegetables. And later, anisotropic shrinkage, which is normally happen in an animal tissues, normally in fish one. And the sinkage, which is occurred due to this moisture loss, and which will help in the ice formation during the freezing. And or also formation of the pores by drying, puffing, and extrusion process. So during this process only, the pores will be formed. And the rheology. So rheology means, which is a science that deals with the deformation and the flow of material under the action of these applied forces. So, or also we can be able to study this deformation, how much amount the material will deform or flow with respect to the stress and the strain characteristics. The stress, which is defined as the force component, which is acting on the body per unit cross-section area, or the area of this deformed specimen. Normally, the stress is a force, and the strain, which is defined as how much amount it is it is defined as a parameters in order to mention the effect. Okay, so if you apply the stress in the product, what happens is it will start to change in the length, or else there might be an difference in size or shape of this product, and that the change is determined by using this string. And there is no specified values or else specified unit for the string. Since it is used to calculate this change in the size and shape, normally it is calculated in terms of percentage only. And it is defined as a body response with respect to the applied forces. And there are examples such as liquid foods, waters, and solid foods. And in liquid foods, the flow of water and ketchup, these are also rheology, study about rheology, and creep about the apples and the grinds cheese. And these are also about the solid foods and the rheology. So the rheology, which is a material, which is defined as the stress and the strain with respect to the certain time. So the behavior of this material under these three common terms is studied by using this rheology. And there are three stresses that is commonly applied in this food in order to characterize this mechanism. One is shear force, compressive force. Compressive force is directed towards the materials, and the tensile force is which is always move this away from the material, and the shearing forces, which is directed tangentially. So there are three forces. Compressive means so which makes the material to shrink in the size. Tensile means which makes a material to move away from the structures, and the shear means normally it is measured as a tangential force. And texture, so texture is defined as a physical characteristics which is arrived from the structural element, and normally the it is determined by the feeling of the touch. If you touch some silk cloth, what you feel is it is soft, so it is having a soft nature. So if you touch a rock, what you feel is you can able to feed a hard nature. So this is known by using the feeling of the touch, or any deformation or any disintegration, or else any flow of the food under the force, and measured objectively by using the function of mass, length, and the time. And this indicates that the structure studies include this normally molecular, microscopic, and macroscopic. And these will react to the applied forces. And for instance, any textural profile analysis, which is widely used in the industries, which uses the mechanical properties such as hardness, fracturability, cohesiveness, springiness, chewiness, and gumminess. So normally, these are all the properties, textural properties, while used in the industries. And aerodynamic properties. So this is the functional properties. So if you want to design any cyclonic separators or any water conveying equipments, you have to get a clear-cut idea about terminal velocities. So terminal velocity means it is the velocity at which the particle is kept in a suspended state. So during an airflow streams, if an airflow stream is there, means at this velocity, the particle will be at a suspended state, which means it will ability to maintain the stability even though when the force of an air stream is applied on this product. And it is normally used in an air and water conveying system and separation equipment. The physical properties such as density, shape, size, and drag coefficient are required for calculating this terminal velocity of material. And for example, if a pneumatic conveying system, the material is, so if you want to lift a grind from one place to the another, so this is a tube. So if you want to lift the tube, what you have to do is, then if these material is lifted one, then this velocity, airstream velocity is greater, means the material is getting lifted. If not so, what happens is the material will be there only. And this is the velocity. It is normally calculated by using this gravitational force, which is equal to the upward drag force. So when the upward drag force, which is equal to the gravitational force, the particle will be in a suspended state. And if this if the density of particle is greater than the density of the fluid, what happens is the particle will starts to move downwards. If it happens vice versa, these particle will be lifted upwards. Okay, then the separation of this mixture wheat and four grain matters is achieved by using an air stream. Then the terminal velocity of each of the components is determined by the range of velocities. So for a different agricultural product, we can be able to calculate a different terminal velocity. For example, wheat, it can be shown that the terminal velocity is about 9 to 11.5 meter per second. For example, for a rye, it is about 8.5 to 10 meter per second. So it will vary for an each agricultural products. And unit density, density also varies for an each agricultural products. Okay. And if an object is moving through an fluid which experiences drag forces, and this is a net force which is happen in the direction of the flow, which is due to the difference in shear and the stress forces. Normally it is calculated by using the formula FD, which is equal to this half rho V squared A into CD, where CD is the drag coefficient, rho is the density of the fluid normally, which is taken as NTP. Or else you can take it at 1.2 kg per meter cube, and V is the pore flow velocity, and A is the characteristics area, surface area. And these are all the different drag coefficient, which is calculated for different values. And then frictional properties. So frictional properties such as coefficient of friction and angle of repose, which is a prime important factor while designing a storage bin, hopper or chutes or pneumatic conveying systems, screw conveyors, and also forage harvester, thresher, etc. And if the rolling resistance or maximum angle of stability in the rolling of round shape, agricultural produce will be used in designing and handling equipment. So if you want to convey fruits and vegetables by grabbing by gravity force, you have to determine the rolling resistance of this product. And there are three kind of friction. One is static friction and the kinetic friction. Static friction means it is defined as a friction which is happen in the product when they are in without any movement, when they are in the surface contact with each other, or else when they are in the rest condition. It is defined as a friction. Then kinetic friction means it is defined as a friction which is existing in the bodies when they are in the relative motion to each other. And the coefficient of friction, normally it is defined as a tangent to the angle of the inclined surfaces. When the frictional force is tangent to the surface and the weight is normal to the surface of acting. So it is a tangent. So in an inclined surface, when we are drawing a tangent, it is known to be the coefficient of friction. Normally, it is calculated as a ratio of a force of friction and the weight of this force which is normal to this surface contact. And normally, this force of friction, which will happen due to the relative motion of these bodies, normally it is calculated by mu is equal to friction force divided by applied normal load. And the coefficient of friction, which will depends upon for which will differ for different properties and also surfacing materials. And also then the angle of the repose. So it is known to be, so if you form and heap, so if you freely form and heap with this material, what happens is it will make an angle with respect to this horizontal surface, and this angle is known to be the angle of repose. And there are two types of the angle of repose. One is static and next one is dynamic. Static means this is the angle of the repose in which the material just slide upon itself. Dynamic angle of the repose means it comes in the picture when the grinds is in motion, like discharge from bin or hoppers, etc. And this is, there are the two types. and the static angle of the repose and the dynamic angle of the repose. So this is known to be the static angle of the repose. So if you are allowed to call it freely. And the second one is, this is known to be the dynamic angle of the repose. So this is the material is while rotating. So while heap is poured, when the material is poured on the flat surface, it will form an heap. This is known to be the angle of the repose. So in a tilting table, it is known to be the angle of the repose. And the rotating cylinder, and this is known to be the angle of the repose. And there is a term, so let me explain it later. So the angle of the repose, which will vary for granular sugar and also powdered sugar also. So dry sand, which is having an angle of the repose, which will not be more than 35 degrees Celsius for a process drying, and also, so it shows that velocity. So this is the red color, which will indicate the maximum velocity, and the yellow color, which will indicate the which is the velocity comparatively smaller to that of this one. And there are, so in these places you can expect this maximum velocity. So if you are allowed to fall it freely, so there you can expect this maximum velocity. And next one is green term. The green term, which will indicate that slightly higher velocity in terms of 0.5 meter per second. So here you can expect a higher velocity. And this one is the term which is having a least velocity. Okay, then angle of the repose, which is normally obtained by the tangential of 2 into HA minus HB, which is height of the cone minus height of the platform divided by diameter of the platform. And this angle of the internal friction, which is equal to this tangent to the coefficient of friction for the material. So it is normally equal to the tan of coefficient of friction of the material. Angle of internal friction, which is normally important factor in designing and lateral pressure in the storaging of the silos. Angle of internal friction also useful in designing and storage and hopper bins. And the coefficient of friction between the grinds are required as designing the parameters for designing of silos and deep bins. And these are all the values for different value of angle of the repose for different grinds. And this is known to be the first one, V, which is having an angle of the repose, which is having in the range of 22 to 28, and the paddy, which is around 30 to 45, and the maize, which is around 30 to 40, and the barley, which is around 28 to 40, and millet, which is sowing about 20 to 25, and the rye, which is around 23 to 28. So this was the paddy, which is having an higher angle of the repose. So then the conclusion, which shows that the enthalpy and specific heat. So normally these are also important term, which we have to discuss it in a later. And the electrical properties also have to be discussed. And the aerodynamic properties are also important in required for designing an air and the water conveying system. And also frictional properties, which is useful in determining and designing a storage bin, hopper, chutes, and pneumatic conveying system, screw conveyors, forage harvester, thresher, so threshers, etc. And